This is after every cleaning.
Look at this.
What's up YouTube? This is Vijay Ansara back with another video, and today's video is about overhauling something. Yeah, it's not the motorcycle, but yes, it's about my cooler. So I have this Kenstar cooler. Let me show you. It's a Glam 15R. Okay, and I recently cleaned it. Unfortunately, I could not make a very, very good video because I was busy in cleaning that stuff. But yeah, so I thought I'll probably make a small video to show you the comparison between the good and the bad one. But yeah, so let's see. I have another cooler as well, same one, just a bigger one, 22 liters. And I have cleaned everything here. If you see here, the whole black thing, and look at this dust, okay? And mine is clean, sparkling, and beautiful. So the whole bucket was cleaned. I have cleaned the whole thing. If I actually have to show you, if you can see here, I cannot see through anything. And if I show mine, it's literally in the daytime, you can actually see the bucket inside. So yeah, what I'm doing is I am not showing you how to open these six bolts, but they are the ones 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I normally use my automated screwdriver, but yeah, this is not working. So what I ended up doing is the manual one, and I have opened up and look at this condition. This is very bad. So I use few things like my power washer, my brains, and basic cleaning stuff which you can find it at home, and that does the magic. So let me start off, and I may not be able to show you the complete process, but I have removed this one right here after removing the bolt, and there's that motor. So I have to remove, I have to remove this one and this bolt right there, this bolt and this bolt, and we would be good to go. For this whole assembly, I have to remove one, two, and you got, most of the things are not there actually. So three, then four here, and five, and 6 and 7. So I'm gonna remove the whole assembly, and this is also something which I have to remove. And sorry, I'm using a torch here, or kind of a lamp, but since it's only 7 p.m. this is the best way to show it to you. So I have to remove the spacer, I mean the lock, and this bolt. It's already rusted. The whole thing will be cleaned with my power washer of Bosch, and this will be cleaned with a special ingredient which you will find it at home, and you will be able to see the amazing results. The only challenge in doing this are the rusted nuts and bolts. So I'll be using WD-40 to see if I can, you know, take them out. So let's start the procedure. I have opened this one. I'm gonna remove the motor first, and it's gonna take some wiggle. Oh, this is gonna be a tough one. Okay, it's coming out. Yep, yep. Yeah, there you go. So the motor is out. I'm gonna keep this dirty thing here, which I'm gonna go inside and later on wash it, and I'll show you the procedure. So here it is. This is the before. I'll take few before and after photos and we'll show you. So here guys, I removed this. As you can see, there were like 1, 2, and there you go, 3, and there was 1, 4, and 5, and there was one inside here. There was one inside, I don't know if the camera can capture here, and there was one here, and There was one somewhere over here. So I used multiple tools I have, and sorry about this, is I'm doing it inside my house, I cannot do it outside. So with the help of this, I have been able to successfully remove this. But before I remove this, I have to remove this guy here. I have to remove this bolt and use WD-40 a little bit and this pull this out. Once this is out, this whole assembly will be out. Then we will have access to the motor screws which are there, one there, one there, and we can then start the cleaning procedure. So let's go ahead. Guys, here it is. I have removed it. Does take you can see this part, this shaft is kind of rusted. This is where certain challenges happen, so be careful. You might have to kind of pull a bit hard, and yeah, this is the whole dirty thing inside. And look at this, the camera, just trust me, just doesn't do the justice. But if I have to show you, it's crazy. Let me see, look at this. So there is no way this fan is going to optimally work, and the whole inside, all the bacteria, everything. And yeah, I could probably show you now where all the bolts were. So here is 1, 2, 3, and there is one at the bottom, 4 and 5, 6, 7, this 8 and this 9. So it all goes around this area. So here go 1, 2, then you have 3, then you have 4, and then you have 5, then you have 6, and then you have 7, 8, 9, all these. So this is the whole wiring setup. I'm gonna pretty much also clean this. I have a very bad habit of overhauling stuff. Now the challenge is somewhat going to be on these nuts and bolts. Let me get some light. Okay, sorry about my entire setup of using the cell phone with the hand, but yeah, these are the ones which are going to be difficult for me. But again, don't worry, things can be sorted. So guys, this is the sensor right here. So you can see this white the black color hall sensor. Okay, this is what has gone inside my this sensor is gone inside my cooler. So the thing is, when the water comes up, this plasticky thing just goes up like this, okay, because of the water level. And when it comes down, that is where your motor stops. So in my case, this one is gone. Okay, the moment I switch it on, this hall sensor, since it's gone, it was switching off my motor, so the cooling will not happen. That is why what I did is I cut off one of the wire, and that's a workaround. But the only challenge is I need to keep an eye on the water level all the time. Now I'll be opening up the motor here, and then clean it off. That is also something which you have to clean for the proper flow. So guys, this is what we have to clean. This is a whole calcium deposit, and that's the same thing inside the whole bucket. This is hard. Okay, it's not like something soft. So if you see, the chips off. Now the whole bucket is off. I have to clean this, and majorly I have to clean the bucket where the water resides, and I have to clean this to make sure it is well and good. The solution which I'm going to give you for this cleaning, I strongly suggest do not use it on any vehicles, cars, or anywhere where you have calcium deposit. Do not use it, I'm telling you. Okay, it's a warning. If you use that solution, which you can easily find at home, you are going to mess up your vehicle or anything else. For example, these fittings, okay, you can see the marks here, it can go. But use it with very caution, just dilute it, use it, try it, and use a power washer to wash it off, or just keep pouring water till all the residue is gone off of that solution. I use a special product which is only made for automotives, and not this one which I'm going to about to show you. Since I don't have that much of quantity, and that product is kind of expensive, since this is plastic, and I'm not worried about the plastic rusting, that you apart from these bolts and all, which I'll be cleaning up later, you can use this. So the solution is, tada, this one. Yeah, This is your floor cleaner, your bathroom cleaner. You can use Harpic or you can use Domex. You just have to apply it, put it on, wait for some time, and then take it further from there. It will clean. For example, let me show you now. I will, it reacts to the body. Okay. Look at that. Do you see the bubbles there? Those are bubbles which are coming out. Okay. But I'm telling you, if you're using it on, I'm telling you, if you're using it on car or anything, see the bubbles, see the reaction. Okay. See the clean thing showing up. Don't use it without dilution or without understanding the acidic nature of this. Okay, you will screw up your vehicle. I have a different product. I pay for that product because that doesn't screw up the vehicles. But yeah, if you really are in a need and you want to do it, you can use it. But make sure you wash it off with enough water and there is no residue, because this Domex will make sure everything is rusted. Okay, because it's acidic. Simple. So I hope you got the point, and yeah, let me clean everything. I can't show you the complete process, but let me clean everything and then show it to you guys. So here it is. You can see a little bit it's cleaned off. One thing you need to remember, that 100% thing, this will, Domex or Harpic will not take off, okay? You can use it wisely, but I would suggest, if since this is like chipping, you might have to use some force like this. I cannot do it with one hand, but if you take some scraper, and if you do like this, things will come off. See? So I suggest you use this. It's not showing up here, but yeah, maybe it will show up here. You see that? So not everything is done by that. So this is mainly used where you have when you want to clean up body parts like this. Okay, of any fiber, this will be more useful. You can still use this, but this kind of induces a bit of more scratches on this. But I agitate, or you can also use a Scotch-Brite and try this. So that's just a tip. So guys, here it is. This is like cleaned up, and only a minute amount is left. I have to use screwdriver and all these things, so this will now go in. Okay, let me see if it's smooth. Yep, and this one will then go on top of this and lock up like this, and this one is again all cleaned up and fit like this, and there you go. The motor is better than before. Yep, the same thing I have to do for the whole bucket. It's a time consuming process, guys. Guys, I just wanted to show you where I would ideally use this, okay? If I cannot use the priors and everything. You look at the condition here, right? So, I am just going to do this. Yeah, I'm gonna agitate it with a brush so it goes everywhere. Main is those things, agitate it, and you gotta understand that you have to keep it for some time, only then this will work. You saw the before, right? Now you later on see what is the after. You can later on see what is the after. Okay, so till that time, yeah, I'm sorry I cannot show you the whole process because I'm doing it alone and using my hands along with holding the camera to clean this up. But yeah, you will surely understand the difference in the video. Okay, let me clean this and agitate and clean this softly. You don't have to brush too much, you just agitate it. Okay. Right here, I'm trying to clean it. You can clean further on this. But this is sort of enough. You can see it yourself, I can still clean it further. But yeah, overall, it's way, way, way better than what it was. So most of the things are cleaned. Let me show you. I am sorry you have to see the scene of my bathroom, but it's pretty clean. There is no way I could do this outside. Everything was... I can still further clean. This is just a little bit of residue. I can still further clean this. And you can see this also pretty much clean. I just have to clean off a bit of a residue out here. This is... You see this, okay? And then you will see the before and after. This is where the Domex is probably going to help me out to remove all this excess. See, it's not going to do 100%. Okay, this guy is not going to do 100%. I have to use a brush and screwdriver and scraper and Scotch-Brite and everything to make it clean. But you see, this is before. Let me show you what is after. So, guys, I just wanted to give you a tip. I took the Domex and I applied, I would bend this like this, and I would apply like 1, 2, 3 all the way down. Then the same side, I would bend like this and apply layer line by line. Just make a crisscross so all the things are, all the areas are covered. And you see here, right? You can't see through at all because of all this. See, it's trying to take this off here, and you can see this will all be clean. Now you can't see through, right? I will show you the after. And I have to now use a brush because these areas are not covered. So I'm going to roll around and make sure. You see, this is actually activated. This is chewing up all the calcium right now. So I just have to make sure every side is done. This way I don't have to literally scrape every inch of this. This takes care of most of it. Then I, whatever is left, I take care of it. So let's see how this goes. So guys, after the clean, here it is. Ta-da! Look at this. I told you, right? There is just like, this is like 95% clean. I can still, for example, this part. But yeah, this is still okay. This is 100 times better than what it was. So, yep. This is done. Then, this is also done. I can still further clean this. But yeah, this is enough. This is more than enough. And let me show you the other part. So look at this. This is, everything is almost clean, this side. And look at the motor. I also took a sandpaper and tried to remove. I still further have to do this. Everything is clean. There's just a little bit of dust, but that's okay. And the motor is looking squeaky clean. here, everything. I'm gonna take this rust off with emery paper. And well, one trick I would like to show you, that once you, if you have normal screws, if you don't have SS, after you put this, put glue gun on top of it, so no water goes, you know, and forms rust on the screws, like what it did here.
In my cooler, I did that.
I put all the screws and then I put glue gun on top of it.
So, guys, here we have the cleaned one. There's just few residues when I cleaned up the grill part. Here's the motor, and you can see everything is beautifully clean. And this is what I was talking about. You can actually use a glue gun and put all the glue gun on top of all the heads. Plus, I actually did the same thing here, here, and here. So the thing is, it doesn't cause a problem. Okay. So yeah, I think this is pretty much good to go. Look at the motor; it's beautiful, awesome, love it. So I hope you like this video, and I'm gonna install everything and show you once again.
So guys, here's the last glimpse of it before I put the cover back. This is after every cleaning. Look at this. And I did apply the glue gun wherever I felt. So yeah, this is the inside. And yep. So I hope you like my video, and thank you very much once again for watching my videos. And yeah, so yeah, after this is the net, and some part of the cleaning is still pending, but yeah, almost everything is done. Everything is good now, and I'm happy with the results. And this is the same thing what I did to my cooler, so my cooler pretty much is same. And yeah, so I hope you like my videos. If you do, please go ahead, do share my videos, and thanks a lot once again, and have a nice day ahead. Bye bye.